It is particularly common in the head, body, and joints. Pain. But where does pain come from? And how do pain relievers work? In response to a trauma, a person only feels pain once the affected cells have reacted to it and have started transmitting pain messages like this. The cell membranes immediately release fatty acids, shown here as long red chains. The fatty acids enter an enzyme, cyclooxygenase, anchored in the cell membrane. This enzyme now functions as a kind of catalyst. The fatty acids arriving at the enzyme are transformed and come out again as pain messenger substances, shown here as a yellow cone. These messenger substances are an exact fit for pain receptors on the nerve endings. There they dock, and the stimulation thus caused is sent on as an electrical signal to the brain via the nerve fibers. The brain receives the information and evaluates it. Only then does the person feel pain. Ouch! The entire complex process takes place in a split second. Now we come to pain relievers. They interrupt the transfer of information. The active ingredient in aspirin, acetylsalicylic acid, affects an important interface in the process. Specifically, the point where the pain messenger substances are created, in the cyclooxygenase. The active ingredient simply blocks access to this enzyme. As a result, fatty acids can neither find their way into the catalyst, nor are they transformed into the pain messenger substance. Less and less pain messenger substance is transmitted. When fewer and fewer pain messenger substances dock, the nerve endings send correspondingly fewer impulses to the brain. The result? The pain abates. A simple principle with a great effect. The active ingredient in aspirin, acetylsalicylic acid, eases pain quickly and effectively, whether in the head, body, or joints.
Bayer. Science for a better life.